Good evening and welcome to my third emergency vehicle review video. Tonight I'm going to review the West Sussex Fire and Rescue Scania CP31 water ladder tender fire engine, which is a UK fire truck from Oxford Diecast in their Oxford commercial range, and the scale is modelled to the 176 00 gauge. So the model has been made to the common 00 gauge railway scale, and you could use this as a scenic vehicle on your layout. The model costs me $14.99 from Model Zone, and the detailing is very good, and this is probably the first British fire truck that I have in my collection, as most of my emergency vehicles that I've collected so far are from the United States and Canada. I do have a code-free Los Angeles fire engine, which I will review in another video, but today I'm going to review the Scania CP31. Likewise, Oxford Diecast issue their models in a Perspex display case with a plastic plinth, which is actually which the fire truck is fitted onto the plinth with two screws, a bit similar to how my model tanks in 172 scale are fitted to their plinths from Del Prado and Dragon Armour. Likewise, you've got the two screws there and there, and you'll need a crosshair Phillips type screwdriver to remove the model if you wish to put it on your model railway. And the base just simply unclips like that. Just a brief overview on the model. You've got your sliding hatch doors, which are free on this side. You've got the cab can take a crew of 6 firefighters, I think, as where the US ones can take a total of 8. You've also got the auxiliary control doors on the back. This is where the hoses and generators would be connected up to the fire engine, as used by the fire crew at emergencies. You've also got painted marker lights and indicators, which is the indicators, the reversing lights and the brake lights. And I think these could be fog lights as well, as with the reverse lights and the indicator repeated on the top as well. You've also got the side warning LEDs, which are here and here. You've also got the siren lights on the support stands where the ladders are, and you've got 3 ladders. You've got a small one there, a large one here, and you've got a medium-sized ladder on there. Designed for all purposes, depending on the emergency, will determine which equipment would be used by the fire crew. You've also got the fuel tank, which is just underneath the access door for the crew at the back. And you've got a basic detailed interior on there as well. I would normally take my vehicles off the plinth, but as the detailing is standard on these models, I'm not going to remove it from the plinth yet until I display it in the cabinet. But likewise, let's go to the front. You've got the etched grille, which has been carefully modelled and painted to replicate the real thing. Got flush glazing, which I think is nice, and to be honest, this is the first Oxford diecast truck vehicle that I've owned before, as I've never really owned anything from this company before in this range. You've got the red and white wasp style checks, bit similar to the black and yellow wasp stripes that you get on shunters. And you've got painted indicators and headlights and the indicator lights on the sides. Great model, good price and good value for money. Whether you are a railway modeler or an emergency vehicle collector like I am, I give the model 9 out of 10. And that concludes my review. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to post them in the comment section below. And thank you for watching.